What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to download a world from your Satisfactory server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Having a backup of your save is a great way to play any heavy work game, since sometimes accidents happen that could set you back hours upon hours of work. While this can be helpful, a lot of games make downloading server saves a bit difficult to do, deferring you from wanting to try. The good news is that Satisfactory is much easier to manage than other games. This includes downloading your save for use as a backup or to use in single player. While the server creates regular backups by default, having an extra copy of your save on your local machine is always a good idea for peace of mind. Let's go over how to do it. Before you can download your save, you'll need to know the name of it first. You can find this pretty easily from inside the game. Start the game and click on the Server Manager menu option. And when the manager opens, click on your server and then click on the Manage Saves option. And a list of your available saves will appear in the menu. Each save will have a date and a timestamp. Find your latest save and make a note of that name. Downloading the save file isn't too different from managing other files in the server's control panel. To do it, first, head to your Apex control panel and click on FTP file access on the left-hand side of the page and then log in. From the FTP page, click on Config, Epic, Factory Game, Saved, Saved Games, and Server. Once you make it into that server folder, you should see a list of files. These are going to be your server's saves. Click on the file with the name of your save, and your browser should start downloading the save for you immediately. Once that download is completed, you can either upload the file to your single player game or save it as a backup for later. Loading your save into a single player game is almost as easy as downloading it from your server. All you need to do is place it in your PC's saves folder. Head to your app data folder by going into your Windows menu and typing %appdata% and then opening the folder. Once you're in the app data folder, head to local, factory game, saved, and save games. You'll see a folder inside with a bunch of numbers for the name. Open it up and drop your server's save file into here. Now that server's save will appear in your list of single player saves the next time you start up the game. If the panel won't download your save, it's most likely because the file is too big to be downloaded through the panel. The best way to fix this is to connect to your server using an FTP client like FileZilla to download the file that way. It's never a bad thing to be prepared, and having an extra copy of your world is a great way to make sure that your progress is safe. Remember that it will only be as updated as when you first download it, so every time you make a really significant change, we recommend re-downloading it again to make sure you have the most up-to-date version of your world. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.